What states should you avoid when you're picking your place to live? Your off-grid, homestead, survivalist, just you want to live in a happy, fun, loving place. How do you decide which states to not pick?
Live happy, fun, loving, and carefree.
So it's chilly here on the homestead today, so charcoal, knit hat, and some gloves. All right, so we always think about the places that we want to move to, but how do you decide the places that you don't want to move to? What states should you avoid at all costs? How can you possibly decide that? And we'll figure that out. And I'm going to give you three bonus states at the end, the states that you should think about moving to, after we talk about all the places that you don't want to be moving to. So, you know, we think about, you start saying, okay, we want to move, we want to get out of the situation that we're in, we're looking at places, what kind of places should we not look at? And, you know, you just can get so overwhelmed. Climate, weather, taxes, property values, you know, your income tax is part of your tax, and the property tax is part of the tax, and how much it costs you to buy the place, and do you have schools for your kids, and do I have to think about earthquakes, or, you know, all these other things, and your brain can just explode as you're trying to, you know, think about and mull over all of these things that you should consider. And I've been sitting here the last few days thinking to myself that I'm just saying, you know, Rob, there has got to be something, one thing that we can look at that we can take into account all of these many, many, many factors that we're trying to weigh. And it just, like, I had my aha moment. The number one resource of any state, every single state, is you and me, the people. We are the number one resource. Let's look at moving company information and U-Haul rental type information, because that's telling us the states that people are leaving. And people leaving a state is an incredibly amazing number one indicator of whether you should consider moving to that state. And because people that are living there are fully aware of all of those factors that are occurring in their state. And if they are packing up their stuff and exiting the state by a moving company or renting a U-Haul and doing it themselves, to me, that is an amazing, awesome, beautiful indicator of how bad it is in that state. So, you know, we talk about that, because the thing is, you know, you can look at population of a state, but states can go up in population because of people moving into the state, and they can be unaware of what's going on. They don't know how bad it is there. And the people that are there birthing babies and having, you know, expanding that way. And then people can, you know, the population goes down from the people that are moving out of the state. And then, of course, people die too. So, you know, those are the variables. And weighing population of a state is difficult. So my thought is, let's look at the people that are moving out of the state by hiring moving companies or renting U-Haul vehicles themselves. Because, as an example, one state that you probably wouldn't even occur on your radar is Louisiana. Why is the population going down? And it actually has been going down for the last 3 or 4 years. Why are people exiting Louisiana? Because you'd be like, you know, New Orleans, warm climate on the Gulf Coast. But it's just, you know, the jobs. I mean, it's the oil industry. If you either work for the oil industry, or you work in a supporting role for the oil industry, or, you know, maybe like a restaurant type of business or that. And that's it. And of course, we all know what's happening with oil industry type jobs right now. So, you know, that's why Louisiana probably isn't on your radar, but the population is going down. People are exiting that state, by relatively large numbers for the population of Louisiana. And again, a state you probably never even would consider. So Louisiana would be a state that you wouldn't want to move to because everybody there is leaving. Two other states, we'll do two at the same time here, that are states that probably wouldn't be on your radar are the state of Wyoming and the state of West Virginia. And your common sense, if you're thinking off-grid, prepper, survivalist, just a place that's nice and quiet that I want to live, you'd be like, well, gee, West Virginia, Wyoming, those are great states. Uh-uh. There's, you know, no jobs. And if you're retired, okay, you know, property taxes, weather is pretty harsh there. Wyoming and West Virginia are states that people are leaving. And my first gut instinct would be those are pretty good places to move to. But you got to think about that, because the problem when people are leaving is states, they're going to spend the money that they're going to spend. They've got all the services that they provide, and they're not going to make cutbacks. State governments, local governments, federal government, they don't spend less money. It just goes up and up and up. So if you're living in one of those states and people are exiting, that puts more and more burden on you and the people that are staying in the state. So you might be thinking, well, I'm just going to retire in a nice, quiet little place and I'm not going to bother anybody and everybody will leave me alone. But it doesn't work that way. The problem is, you know, revenue has to be met for the state. And if people are leaving, they're going to get that revenue in any way that they can. So the three big states that you probably are aware of and thinking about are California, Illinois, and New York State. And those are pretty obvious, I hope. And again, like California, Elon Musk is leaving, you know, big businesses are leaving. People that earn a lot of money are leaving the state. And they're getting an influx of immigrants into the state. So, you know, you've got to think about that population demographic. So you might pick a spot in California, again, thinking that that's a great place for me to live. I'll just don't bother anybody. I don't have kids in school anymore. I don't care about that. But as people exit and exit and exit, and the people that are exiting are the people they're taking their money with them, and the people that are coming into the state don't have money, what's that going to do to you? More and more regulations, more and more taxes. And boy, we all know how wonderful the governor is out there in California. Not. So, and again, it's the same thing. Illinois is the same problem. A situation with Illinois that is typical to quite a few states is you've got the big state of Illinois, and Chicago is up there in the corner, and literally half the population of the state, give or take, is in Chicago and the surrounding suburbs. So, you know, roughly ballpark, you know, 10 million people live there. And then the rest of the state is relatively rural. So as the people are exiting Illinois because of their ridiculous taxes, their ridiculous regulations, you know, trying to afford a home there, and young people, you know, are moving to other states, is the people that are left behind are burdened with picking up. So then they raise the taxes more and they cut back on services, but they don't charge less. And it's just this, I hate to use the word death spiral, but that's what ends up happening. And New York is in the same situation. And New York is, I mean, people are exiting this state by a massive amount of people. I mean, they are just fleeing the state of New York. And you've got New York City, and then, I mean, a lot of New York is beautiful. The you know, upstate area and that, and the western part of the state. You know, it's a gorgeous state. Beautiful, beautiful scenery and land and that. But it's controlled by the high population area. So these are the things that, you know, you want to think about. And again, to me, and you can double check it, look at how many people are leaving the state. And it's all relative to each state. And a state I would never think of is like Louisiana. I would certainly never think of Wyoming or West Virginia. My gut instinct would be good states. And then, of course, your big high population states like California, Illinois, New York, that are just massively expensive to live in and high tax and everything like that. So where are these people going to? Where are all the people that are packing up their belongings and heading on down the highway? Where are they going to? What is the, quote, bonus states that people are moving to? And I'll just give them as the three top states in no particular order, if you will, so I'm not favoring anybody. You can look it up if you wanted to figure it out. But the three biggies are Texas, Tennessee, and Florida. Those are the states that everybody's going to. So when you're deciding where you want to live and where you don't want to live, hopefully this information will help you out. And, you know, because you may decide you don't want to move to a state that everybody else is moving to, because are they eventually going to end up like the states that you're trying to leave? So weigh those options, weigh those factors. I'm really proud of myself that I figured out to think about moving companies and rental U-Haul type things for the situations for the states that people are exiting and the states that the people that are exiting where they're headed to. Watch another video. Subscribe if you're not already subscribed, so you'll be notified when my next amazing, wonderful, awesome video comes out. So you can live happy, fun-loving, and of course, carefree.